Elizabeth Cady once said, "The best protection any woman can have is courage." And Bhavri Devi is the epitome of courage. A woman behind the foundation of Vishakha guidelines and the sexual harassment of women at workplace, Prevention, Prohibition and Redressal Act 2013. India's women celebrated a landmark moment in 1997 when the Supreme Court formulated the Vishakha guidelines that made it mandatory for institutions across the country to put in place measures to prevent and redress sexual harassment at workplace. That means the formation of Sexual Harassment of Women at Workplace Prevention, Prohibition and Redressal Act 2013. But how did these guidelines come into existence in the first place? And who is Bhavri Devi and what is Vishakha? Bhavri Devi is a Dalit woman from Bhaderi, Rajasthan. In the year 1985, she was employed by the Rajasthan government's Women Development Project as Sathin. Sathin means friend in Hindi. And her job was to spread awareness about hygiene, family planning, and the necessity of educating girls, along with campaigning against female feticide. In 1992, the family of Ram Karan Gurjar had made arrangements to perform the wedding of his 9-month-old girl. Bhavri Devi, abiding by the work assigned to her, tried to persuade the family not to perform the marriage of only 9-month-old girl. But all her attempts resulted in futility. The family decided to go ahead with the marriage. Her campaign was subjected to disapproval and ignorance by all the members of the village, even though they were aware that child marriage is illegal. On 5th May 1992, the sub-divisional officer, along with the deputy superintendent of police, went and stopped the said marriage. However, the marriage was performed the next day, and no police action was taken against it. Later, it was established by the villagers that the police visited were a result of Bhavri Devi's actions. This led to boycotting Bhavri Devi and her family, and Bhavri also lost her job amid of this boycott. On 22nd September 1992, to seek vengeance, 5 men from the Gurjar family, Ramsu Gurjar, Gyarsa Gurjar, Ram Karan Gurjar and Badri Gurjar, along with Shavan Sharma, had attacked Bhavri Devi's husband and later brutally gang-raped Bhavri. The investigation into Bhavri's case right from start was fraught with problems. The police had tried all possible ways to avoid filing any complaint against the accused, which resulted in a delayed investigation. Even after facing so much criticism, Bhavri Devi, with her incessant determination to get justice, managed to lodge a complaint. Although the medical examination was delayed for 52 hours. However, the examiner did not mention any commission of rape in the report, instead mentioned the victim's age. In the absence of sufficient evidence, all the accused managed to get an acquittal in the trial court. But this acquittal resulted in massive backlash from many women activists and organizations which supported Bhavri Devi. A nationwide network of women's organizations decided to support Bhavri Devi's fight for justice. The movement was led by groups in Rajasthan and Delhi, and these groups were Vishakha and Women's Rehabilitation Group from Rajasthan and Jagori and Kali for Women from Delhi. These organizations came together and raised their voice to attend justice, which resulted in filing of a public interest litigation, majorly by the group Vishakha. It laid its focus on the enforcement of the fundamental rights of women at the workplace under the provisions of Article 14, 15, 19 and 21 of the Constitution of India. It also raised the issue of the need for the protection of women from sexual harassment at the workplace, because according to them, Bhavri Devi was attacked at what was essentially her workplace. There were three major issues which was raised. The first one is whether sexual harassment at the workplace amounts to a violation of rights to gender inequality and the right to life and liberty. Second issue, whether the court could apply international law in the absence of applicable measures under the existing. And the third issue was whether the employer has any responsibility when sexual harassment is done to or by its employee. At that time, the lack of law that would prevent sexual harassment and provide women with a safe working environment was acknowledged by the Honorable Supreme Court of India. Section 354 and 354A of the Indian Penal Code 1860 were to be referred in any case of sexual harassment, but these provisions were not specific to the issue at hand. This made the Honorable Court realize the need for proper and effective legislation that would deal with sexual harassment. The Honorable Supreme Court took a reference from the international conventions to proceed with the case. It referred to the Beijing Statement of Principle on the Independence of Judiciary in the Lavassia region, and also from the provisions of conventions on the elimination of all forms of discrimination against women. Thereby, in 1997, the Honorable Supreme Court formulated the Vishakha guidelines that made it mandatory for institutions across the country to put in place measures to prevent and redress sexual harassment at the workplace. Although the Vishakha guideline is lengthy, but I'll tell some of the key features of Vishakha guidelines. Mainly, the employer or other responsible persons are bound to preclude such indecent incidences of sexual harassment from happening. And apart from it, they must understand what exactly come under the definition of sexual harassment. Apart from it, measures for prevention must take place. There must be proceeding in case of misconduct. There must be appropriate disciplinary action, and there must be redressal mechanism by the redressal committee. One thing which is the best part of the sexual harassment of women at workplace prevention, prohibition and redressal act 2013 is, it is not only for company or any specific organization. It is for every woman who is working, no matter she is a domestic help. She is also having a right to raise her voice against any sort of sexual harassment when she is at her workplace. So that is the story of Bhavri Devi, a woman behind Vishakha guidelines and the Sexual Harassment of Women at Workplace Act. I salute her for her courage, fearlessness, determination, and fight for justice.